All right, hello everybody, and welcome to the last, presumably last, vehicle upcoming content video on the new season of the Battle Pass coming to War Thunder very, very soon. This time we're taking a look at a vessel. So there are two ground vehicles, one aircraft, and now a vessel. The two ground vehicles, in case you haven't seen, Germany is getting the SDKFZ 25122 as a reward. France is getting the EBR 1963, if I remember correctly, as a reward. And Japan is getting the A6M6C fighter aircraft as a reward. And now, for naval forces, the United States is getting the USS Detroit, or CL-8, so light cruiser we're looking at here. So, just to get this out of the way right now, obviously it's been a bit of a mixed opinion type of upcoming content videos we've done for the past few. I was very unhappy with the EBR, very unhappy. It was a 20-minute rant video, basically, right? And a lot of other people were also very unhappy. I was also pretty unhappy with the SDKFZ 25122. The reasons for these were, obviously, the SDKFZ is yet another light vehicle that's yet another event collectible for Germany. They barely are getting any of those on their standard tech tree to play around with. All the alternate variants of the 234, for example, the 2341, 2343, 2344, all of those were event vehicles. Then they added the 251, an iconic German half-track, and they added the first one as an event collectible. But I thought that that was somewhat acceptable at the time because it was a really, like, obscure variant. And now we're finally getting a pack version of that, and it's another collectible, right? The only thing they got for the 251 was a standalone anti-aircraft variant on the tech tree, which in and of itself was basically just as obscure. So a lot of people are a little bit unhappy with that. The EBR, I don't think we need to go through the explanation again, but essentially, long story short, one of France's most important wheeled vehicles and both of the ones that have been added to the game have been collectibles. And a lot of people pointed out to me, as I said, there's not many variants to go around, but there are more to choose from. They could still put one. So a lot of people pointed out that, yeah, the last one that they could pretty much add to the game right now is the worst variant. So why not just put that on the standard tech tree, right? So a lot of people aren't very happy with that, and I totally understand, and I wasn't very happy with it either. The A6M6, I said, was relatively acceptable. I thought that that was fine as an event collectible. But now that it's fine as a collectible, people have shifted their complaint over to it being a copy-paste unit, even though that completely disregards the actual definition of copy-paste, or clone, as, like I said, people seem to be calling it now. The same thing is being directed at the USS Detroit, which is another variant of a ship that we pretty much already have in the game. And again, people don't understand the concept of copy-paste. Especially with naval forces, where you are going to see this kind of thing a lot because of the nature of sister ships and the fact that Gaijin adds ships. Right now, it looks like they might be adding ships of different fits. So you might get the same ship three times in the game, not even sister ships. I'm talking the same physical ship three times throughout the course of this game's development, but each one might have a different fit of weaponry or anti-aircraft weaponry, etc., because that's just the nature of how naval combat worked at the time. You know, and like I said, look at the large ships for nations, okay? I'm not talking destroyers where there's like 700 destroyers per freaking nation. Just look at the large ships, the classes. There aren't hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of classes of ships to go around for each individual nation. Each nation had some had a good number, some had a handful, some even only had a few classes of large ships, battleships and heavy cruisers, etc. And then each of these ship classes had four or more, sometimes three or less, sisters in there. So you had the lead ship of the class, and then you had the sister ships. So you might have had four of one battleship because each of them are sisters, but their gun layout might be different. So you're going to get that kind of thing in this game. This isn't anything to do with copy-paste. This isn't laziness. This is just how it is. Now, I have seen some people complain about how the USS Detroit had a better fit, and Gaijin chose to add the event version as one that doesn't have really much of a different fit to the Raleigh that's in the game right now. I believe I saw someone comment on that. Can't say for sure myself, but like I said, there are different fits for different ships, so they could have chosen a better one for this. But at the same time, look at a lot of the premium vessels. Gaijin has prioritized making premium vessels the better sister so far, which has been very annoying. Like the Eugen, for example, on the German tech tree. And I think some people have also mentioned the same for the Mikuma. Although the Mogami obviously has presumably much better weaponry, but the Eugen, I think, is some of the better example in regards to that. So I haven't really been too much a fan of that, but at least it's available in the game. Even if it's paid content, at least it's available at all times and not a limited time thing that forces you to basically sell your soul in order to get it, or spend money on a limited supply of them and pay out ridiculous prices for them, etc. Right? That's kind of my whole spiel. Someday I will do a full freaking rant video that's like 2 hours long on why I absolutely despise when this community brings up the copy-paste argument, because it is the dumbest fucking thing I've ever heard basically since I was born. The second dumbest thing being my own birth. But we're taking a look at the USS Detroit for right now. And we're not going to talk about how this thing is just a copy-paste, as pretty much everyone else seems to only give a shit about. So, fast and well-armed, the light cruiser USS Detroit, CL-8, is one of the prizes in the upcoming new season of War Thunder's Battle Pass. USS Detroit, or CL-8, is a light cruiser for the United States of the 3rd rank, and it is a premium, so far all four of the vehicles are premiums for this. Pros are that it has most of the main caliber guns that are located in the front, good max speed, punchy AAA battery, and premium bonuses. Cons are that it has poor protection. So we'll take a look at the history here. And there you can go. You can take a look at that if you're interested. And now we have some screenshots of the vessel. It's not a bad looking vessel. Very old classic style look of ship build here. You can see it's got even some casemate guns in here. It's got reconnaissance aircraft, which I've heard talk about how there was reconnaissance aircraft being tested at some point. I don't know much about that. I didn't take part in any of that. So, you know, with how little I've been following War Thunder's development news recently, I couldn't tell you exactly what's going on with that. And here we've got a shot of the front of the vessel here. And you can see, we've got a dual gun turret here, as well as what look like four casemate guns. So that's probably what what they mean by, what the hell is wrong with my throat? That's probably what they mean by most of the guns facing forward, which is beneficial for, well, basically going straight at an enemy ship. Obviously, trying to get a broadside shot in naval forces can output a ton of damage, but you're also putting yourself at great risk from various different kinds of attacks. So in War Thunder, the USS Detroit light cruiser will be one of the prizes in the upcoming Battle Pass. The ship is a striking representative of the Omaha-class, with all of its inherent advantages and disadvantages. Let's take a look in more detail. So when creating USS Detroit CL-8, as well as other light cruisers of this class, the priority characteristics were the speed and firepower. Detroit's top speed is 35 knots, or 65 kilometers an hour, which is quite good for the class of warships. The main caliber of the light cruiser is 152mm guns, located in two twin gun turrets and a single gun casemate mountings, 10 barrels in total. So there's 10 casemates in total, really? I counted there's four here and two in the back. That's six. Where are the rest? I'll take a look at the screenshots when we look. The cruiser is protected from aviation at low altitudes by 10 20mm cannons and two quadruple 28mm autocannons. In addition, Detroit also has two triple tube torpedo launchers. As for the weak sides of the Omaha class, they are also known to enthusiasts of War Thunder's Blue Water Fleet. First, the ship does not take a hit well. The USS Detroit armored belt in the Citadel area is no more than 76mm thick, while only the engine room and part of the ammo stowages are hidden behind the armor. The superstructure, bridge, gun casemates can only offer protection from bullets and shrapnel. Even destroyers pose a threat. There is even no need to talk about other light cruisers. It would seem that this is the verdict of the ship's playability. Well, no, sir, because Omaha-class light cruisers provide interesting gameplay opportunities due to the fact that most of the main battery guns are concentrated at the fore of the ship. If you fire towards the enemy in a strictly frontal projection and at a considerable distance, a large caliber will do its job. At the same time, Detroit is perfectly protected from air attacks. We heartily recommend loading 76mm guns with distance-fused shells for battle at long-range air targets. A battery of 20mm autocannons will help protect against low-flying strike aircraft. USS Detroit's premium status will allow you to quickly explore U.S. blue water ships and earn significantly more Silver Lions in battle. And here we've got some screenshots of the vessel from above. There you can see some more of... Are those main guns there? No, because then that would imply that there's six guns. They look like cannons, though. I don't know where the other casemate guns are then. Because if you've got four in the front, and one right here and one on the opposite side, that's only six guns. If you count these, that's going to put you up to... Huh. Well, let me go ahead and look here, because I'm actually curious myself. Yeah, there's one, two, three, four. Fuck, I don't get fuck. I don't know where the other ones are. So the American Light Cruiser USS Detroit is a worthy reward for progressing in the War Thunder Battle Pass. That's coming very soon. So there you go, guys. That's the naval vessel. And like I said, maybe someday I'll just stop complaining about the copy-paste stuff in the actual devlog videos and instead do its own dedicated video. Not that my War Thunder content is very popular anymore anyways. It's obviously gone downhill since I don't cover War Thunder religiously anymore like I used to. But there are still quite a few dedicated viewers on my channel who have been around for a few years that still watch my War Thunder content when I produce it. We'll see. No promises, but I mean, I don't know. Let's look at the comments here and see. Well, there you go. Top comment is paid BP full of clones. There's that new term, I guess, that people are using now, clones. Possibly the worst BP vehicle so far. It's obviously just a perspective thing. See, this person here is the one I was referencing that was talking about... That was talking about the fact that they could have added Detroit with a better fit that's not so similar to Raleigh. That way it was a little bit more unique. So the only difference being a twin 20mm cannon. While in her late fit, she gains three twin 40mm and more 20mm in exchange for two of her casemates, etc. So, and then he says that would have been actually unique. And a late war Omaha is currently missing in the game. So... basically, I'm just looking at, we already have two Omahas in the game, why do we need a third? It's absolutely trash currently with the BR compression. Well, that's always been War Thunder, the BR compression shit. Still US to flip line, but a bit disappointing. Omaha again. You know, I don't know. Like, we'll talk about it later in a different video about this, the complaints that people give for this kind of stuff. From a gameplay perspective, obviously people saying that, like, the Omaha-class not being fun to play, that's a completely different ball game. That's not the ball game I'd be touching. That's a perspective ball game or a boo-boo ball game. This is purely about the argument regarding adding a quote-unquote copy-paste vehicle to the game, when that's just not how it fucking works. It just doesn't make any sense to me.